customers, here we start with the part 2 of the hip joint, ligaments of the hip joint. So, ligaments of hip joint. Now, first ligament, fibrous capsule. Second ligament, synovial membrane. Most of the books, they have considered fibrous capsule and synovial membrane as one ligament. Here we consider it differently. To understand it, the entire gross anatomy of both the attachments. So fibrous capsule, then synovial membrane. Then we start with the acetabular labrum. Then number 4, we are having the transverse acetabular ligament. Then number 5, we are having the ligamentum teres femoris. So it is called ligamentum teres femoris, or it will be known as ligament of head of femur. Then number 6, we are having the iliofemoral ligament, or the other name of iliofemoral ligament is ligament of Bijlo or Bijlo, either way you can pronounce. So it is ligament of Bijlo, B-I-G-E-L-O-W, Bijlo. So that is ligament, the iliofemoral ligament or ligament of Bijlo, number 6. Then number 7, we are having the pubofemoral ligament, pubofemoral ligament. And the last one, number 8, the last one will be known as ischiofemoral ligament, ischiofemoral ligament. Now, this is how you have to remember in sequence. All the 8, please try and remember in sequence. We are going to describe each one of them. We start with fibrous capsule. So let us start with the fibrous capsule. For the fibrous capsule, this is the ideal diagram. The same diagram here. Here we have the head and neck of the femur, including greater and lesser trochanter. This is the neck, this is the head, this is the greater trochanter, lesser trochanter, this is the entire femur. Very easy, very easy to understand. Now here we go with the acetabular margin. And for the acetabular margin, this is the cross section. This is the cross section, the acetabular margin, the acetabular cavity. And inside, on this femur, we are going to show there will be fovea. This is the fovea, where there is attachment of the ligamentum teres femoris. So it is the ligament of the head of the femur. This is the ligamentum teres femoris. This is ligamentum teres femoris, which is attached. And this acetabular margin, we will slightly broaden it so that we produce some space inside. So we are going to broaden this cavity so enough space is produced in this way. And now, fibrous capsule. Please note down, with the fibrous capsule we are going to draw with the yellow color. The entire fibrous capsule will be taut in extension and it will become relaxed in flexion. This sometimes is asked in MCQ one mark question answer. The fibrous capsule of the hip joint will be taut, T-A-U-T, in extension, and it will become relaxed in flexion of the hip joint. Same way, the fibrous capsule is attached at two ends, upper end to the acetabular margin, lower end to the femur. Now, where is it attached? That is what we are going to discuss. The upper margin of fibrous capsule will be attached on the acetabular margin, 5 to 6 mm above the acetabular labrum. Where acetabular labrum, fibrocartilage, where it is attached on acetabular margin, just 5 to 6 mm above that acetabular labrum will be the attachment of the upper part of fibrous capsule. So the fibrous capsule will be attached here on the acetabular margin, 5 to 6 mm above the acetabular labrum. So this is the acetabular attachment of fibrous capsule. What will be the femoral attachment of fibrous capsule? the femoral attachment of fibrous capsule will be, it will be attached on intertrochanteric line, and anteriorly this is intertrochanteric line between the greater trochanter and the lesser trochanter. So here on the intertrochanteric line is anteriorly where the femoral attachment, lower attachment of fibrous capsule is there. What will be posteriorly, posterior attachment of fibrous capsule on the femur? Posteriorly, similarly, there will be trochanteric crest connecting the two trochanters, greater and lesser trochanter, posteriorly. So it will be attached around 1 centimeter medial to and above the trochanteric crest. So posteriorly also it will be attached around 1 centimeter medial and superior to trochanteric crest. This is the femoral attachment. Also you have to note down that here anteriorly, as it is attached on the intertrochanteric line, it will be attached superiorly at the base of greater trochanter, and inferiorly it will be attached in front of lesser trochanter. So this completes the lower attachment of the capsule. Now this entire capsule, this entire capsule will be covering the neck, head and neck of the femur. So therefore there will be space between this capsule and the neck of the femur. Through that space, synovial membrane will have an outpouching to form a bursa for obturator externus muscle. This is an additional point which you need to note down. It will form an outpouching which acts as the bursa for obturator externus muscle. This you can mark it as one mark question answer. After this attachment, after you understood the attachment of fibrous capsule on acetabular margin and on femur, now next point will be reticular fibers. What are reticular fibers? From the lower attachment on the femur, where the fibrous capsule is attached on intertrochanteric line of femur, from here some fibers will be passing upwards and medially in this way. They will pass upwards and medially deep to the capsule, and these fibers, they are known as, what are they called? Retinacular fibers. They are the fibers of the capsule only, from intertrochanteric line passing upwards medially deep, and they are called retinacular fibers. For what purpose these retinacular fibers are there? They will allow the passage of the blood vessels to the head and neck of femur. So various blood vessels will pass through these retinacular fibers, which will supply the head and neck of the femur, and therefore these retinacular fibers will allow passage of blood vessels to the head and neck of femur. In cases of intracapsular fracture of the neck of the femur, these retinacular fibers are stretched or they are torn, as a result of which the blood vessels which they carry will be destroyed, as a result of which the blood supply to the head and neck of the femur will suffer. It will not receive the blood supply, head and neck of the femur, because the vessels are torn in intracapsular fracture of the neck of femur. This much you have to understand. And lastly, the last point in fibrous capsule will be, this is very important, the deepest fibers of capsule, the deepest fibers of the capsule will form zona orbicularis. They form circular fibers and they form zona orbicularis. This zona orbicularis is continuous with our last ligament. And what is the name of the last ligament? Ischiofemoral ligament. So zona orbicularis is continuous with ischiofemoral ligament. So note down that the deepest fibers of the capsule, they are circular, they are called zona orbicularis, and they are continuous with the ischiofemoral ligament. Now here, since we have discussed about the entire capsule, now we are going to discuss synovial membrane. This is very important. Please try and understand the synovial membrane after capsule. Synovial membrane will lie just beneath the capsule. So what are the attachments of synovial membrane? The attachments of synovial membrane will be, for example, I will use blue color. Please note down the attachments. Number one, the synovial membrane will line inner surface of the capsule. It will line the inner surface of the capsule. So please line this inner surface of the capsule. Number one, synovial membrane lines inner surface of the capsule. Number two, synovial membrane will line inner surface of the neck. Inner surface of the neck of the femur. So it will line the inner surface of the neck of the femur. Number two. Number three, it will stop at the level of hyaline cartilage, at the level of articular cartilage. And remember, yesterday we had discussed this hyaline cartilage is attached on the femur in such a way that this cartilage is very thick in the center, and at the periphery this cartilage is very thin. This way the hyaline cartilage is attached on the femur, head of the femur. So this is hyaline cartilage. So our synovial membrane will stop at hyaline cartilage. Remember, it will not line the articular cartilage. This hyaline cartilage is also called articular cartilage. Similar hyaline cartilage is found on the lunate fossa. So here, this is the similar cartilage. And here, this is the similar articular cartilage which is lining the lunate fossa. And this lunate fossa also we have discussed, it is in the acetabular cavity. So these two are the articular cartilages. They are devoid of synovial membrane. Simple, that point should be noted. So synovial membrane, number one, it will line the inner surface of fibrous capsule. Number two, it will line the neck of the femur. Number three, it will stop at articular cartilage. It will stop at the margin of articular cartilage. So here, if you continue, it is stopping here. Also over here, it will stop here. Here it is stopping, and here also it will stop. It will not cover the articular cartilage of the head of the femur as well as the lunate surface of the acetabular cavity. That is point number three. Now point number four, it will cover the ligamentum teres femoris. This ligamentum teres femoris here, which I have drawn, it will cover this entire ligament. So here, if I show this ligament, I am going to show that this synovial membrane is covering this ligamentum teres femoris in this way. So it will form a conical covering of ligamentum teres femoris. And on the femur, it will be attached at the fovea. That fovea where ligamentum, apex of the ligamentum teres femoris is attached, on the margins of fovea, this synovial membrane is attached. That is point number four. So this is point number four. Be very clear. It will form a conical sheath-like covering on ligamentum teres femoris. Point number one, it will cover the inner surface of fibrous capsule. Point number two, it will cover the neck of the femur. Point number three, it will stop at the articular cartilage. It will not cover articular cartilages. Point number four, it will form a biconical sheath covering the ligamentum teres femoris, and it is attached at the margins of the fovea on the head of femur. And point number five, it will cover acetabular fat which is present in the acetabular fossa. So there will be lot of fat which will be present here. There will be lot of fat which is present here in acetabular fossa, which will be known as acetabular fat. So here synovial membrane will cover the acetabular fat. And therefore, that is point number five. It will cover the acetabular fat which is present in acetabular fossa. Therefore, we will mark here, this is ligamentum teres femoris. Here, this is the synovial membrane. This is the acetabular band over here. So all these things we have to mark. So this is about the entire synovial membrane. Coming back here, we have finished fibrous capsule and synovial membrane, all the important points. Now we come to ligament number 3, acetabular labrum. Acetabular labrum, yesterday we have discussed, if we come on this side, please come on this side. Now here, if you draw the entire lunette shaped acetabular margin, then we are going to show that the acetabular labrum, it is covering, if I use here orange color, then it will be covering the margin of the acetabular cavity. This is where acetabular labrum is attached, on the margin of acetabular cavity. Attachment of acetabular labrum, fibrocartilage which is attached on the margin of acetabular cavity, except at acetabular notch. So here it is deficient. This is acetabular notch. And this is the lunette surface. This is the lunette surface. This is the acetabular labrum. Now this acetabular labrum will be continuous with fibrous capsule. Remember, the fibrous capsule will continue with the fibers of acetabular labrum. The entire fibrous capsule, as it comes down, it will cover the anterior surface of acetabular labrum. So the fibrous capsule and acetabular labrum, as they come down anteriorly, they are joined together. They will, the fibers of fibrous capsule and acetabular labrum will merge. So this is acetabular labrum, fibrocartilaginous attachment on the acetabular margin. Then we come to, if you come on this side, after finishing acetabular labrum, this is transverse acetabular ligament. Once again, please come on this side, transverse acetabular ligament. If I bridge this, transverse acetabular ligament will cover the acetabular notch. And this transverse acetabular ligament is also known as the continuation of acetabular labrum minus the cartilage cells, because acetabular labrum is fibrocartilage, so it has abundance of cartilage cells. But this transverse acetabular ligament is nothing but continuation of the acetabular labrum only, where it is continuous across the acetabular notch, but it does not have cartilage cells. So therefore, this will be known as transverse acetabular ligament. So here we finish, please come on this side, the transverse acetabular ligament. Now we come to ligamentum teres femoris, we come up. So here, ligament number 5 is ligamentum teres femoris, or ligament of head of femur. If we please come on this side, now this ligamentum teres femoris, the base of ligamentum teres femoris will be attached on transverse acetabular ligament. So I am going to draw this base like this. So this is how ligamentum teres femoris, the base is attached. Apex of this ligamentum teres femoris will be attached. Here we cannot show the apex because we are having lack of space. Basically the apex is attached on the fovea. The fovea is present on the middle of the articular surface of the head of femur. We know that. So the apex of ligamentum teres femoris will be attached on the fovea, which is present on the head of the femur. And the base of ligamentum teres is attached on transverse acetabular ligament. Now this ligamentum teres femoris, many times it is asked in one mark question answer or in MCQs that this ligament will become taut in adduction of the hip joint. During adduction of the hip joint, this ligamentum teres femoris will become tight, or it will become taut, or it will be tensed up. In case of abduction of the hip joint, in case of abduction of hip joint, this ligamentum teres femoris will be relaxed. Please note down. Please come on this side. So after finishing this ligamentum teres femoris, we come to the three very important ligaments. And those three will be, first we take this iliofemoral ligament, or ligament of Bijoux. For the iliofemoral ligament, please come here. I'm going to rub this, and then we are going to draw another diagram, very simple line diagram, where we understand the entire attachment of ligament of bulge lophodet. Here this is the greater trochanter. This will be the entire head and neck of the femur. Similarly, on this side, please draw in dotted margin. So we are going to cover this entire space. Now here we are going to show the margin of acetabulum. This is the acetabular margin, anterior superior iliac spine, as well as we are going to show anterior inferior iliac spine. This much we are going to show. This is the cross section here, obturator foramen we are going to show, and also the entire hip bone. This much. So obturator foramen, the anterior superior iliac, anterior inferior spine, and this is the ischium and the ramus. Now it is very important that iliofemoral ligament, it is the strongest ligament, one of the strongest ligament of the human body. It is called ligament of Bulge loop. This iliofemoral ligament is inverted Y-shaped. Inverted Y-shaped, that is very important. And this ligament will be attached in such a way that here you draw this as intertrochanteric line. Just draw this as intertrochanteric line. And our iliofemoral ligament will be inverted Y-shaped. It is one of the strongest ligament of the human body, and the stem of the Y superiorly, it will be attached on the iliac spine. It will be attached on anterior inferior iliac spine. So let us consider this as anterior inferior iliac spine. On this anterior inferior iliac spine, there will be attachment of the stem of the iliofemoral ligament. So therefore, here I am going to show this as the stem of attachment of iliofemoral ligament. And therefore, this here I am going to mark this as anterior inferior iliac spine. So upper attachment is over. Lower down, as the iliofemoral ligament comes down, it is divided into two bands, medial and lateral band. The lateral band will be more laterally diverted. This is the lateral band, and it is attached on upper part of intertrochanteric line. This is the attachment of upper part of intertrochanteric line, the lateral band of iliofemoral ligament. The medial band, as it comes down, the medial band will be attached on the lower part of intertrochanteric line. So it will be attached here in the lower part of intertrochanteric line. Similarly, the intermediate part, it is attached on the intertrochanteric line. It is also attached on intertrochanteric line. So basically the iliofemoral ligament will be attached on entire intertrochanteric line only. But the lateral band is attached in the upper part of intertrochanteric line, and the medial band will be attached on the lower part of intertrochanteric line, with the intermediate part attached on the intertrochanteric line. But here in the intermediate part, it will be pierced by, here we have to draw, it will be pierced by ascending branch of lateral circumflex femoral artery. This is a one mark question answer. So here it is pierced by the ascending branch of lateral circumflex femoral artery. This is an asked in MCQ. Ascending branch of the lateral circumflex femoral artery. This is the iliofemoral ligament, Y-shaped. The stem is attached to anterior inferior iliac spine, lower down, medial and lateral bends, and we know that this is the attachment of iliofemoral ligament. Now this iliofemoral ligament will prevent hyperextension. One more question answer. It will prevent the hyperextension of the hip joint. And second important point which you need to understand will be, this iliofemoral ligament is the strongest ligament, one of the strongest ligament of human body. It will prevent the falling back of the pelvis. As we know that the line of gravity will pass behind the hip joint. As the line of gravity passes behind the hip joint, there is a tendency of natural tilting back of the pelvis. The human pelvis has a natural tendency of falling back because the line of gravity passes behind the hip joint. This is prevented by iliofemoral ligament. Please note down. These are the important points of iliofemoral ligament. Now we come to our next ligament. Please come on this side. We will mark it so it will be easy. The pubofemoral ligament. And this pubofemoral ligament, please come here once again. Same, the pubofemoral ligament will be attached above to the iliopubic eminence. So here if I show this yellow color, this is iliopubic eminence. It is attached on iliopubic eminence and obturator crest. Upper attachment is on iliopubic eminence and obturator crest. That is pubofemoral ligament. Pubofemoral ligament is attached on iliopubic eminence and obturator crest. So therefore, here I will mark this as the iliofemoral ligament, and this I will mark it as pubofemoral ligament, and this is the iliopubic eminence. Iliopubic eminence and obturator crest. And lower down, this pubofemoral ligament will merge with the medial band of iliofemoral ligament. So lower down it will merge with the medial band of iliofemoral ligament, the pubofemoral ligament. This is how pubofemoral ligament is attached. The space between pubofemoral and iliofemoral ligament here, in this space there is opening of a psoas bursa. This is one more question answer. Now here I will show the bursa. Please draw this and we will mark it as the opening of psoas bursa. This is very much frequently asked in MCQs and one mark question answer. The opening of psoas bursa, please note down here, psoas bursa. So through this opening of psoas bursa, the psoas bursa can communicate with the synovial cavity of the hip joint. Where does the psoas bursa open? In between pubofemoral and iliofemoral ligaments. Please note down. So here we finished pubofemoral ligament. Now please come on this side. The last ligament, ischiofemoral ligament. Now ischiofemoral ligament, once we draw this ischiofemoral ligament here, once again we'll come back here. In the ischiofemoral ligament, what we need to show will be that if I rub here, on this segment I can show the, if I show, this is the ischial tuberosity. Now here I need to show this is the ischial tuberosity on this side. Similarly here I need to show the greater trochanter, and remember this is lesser trochanter, this is greater trochanter, greater trochanter, and this one will be ischial tuberosity. This rough line diagram is posterior view, the posterior part. We are looking at ischial tuberosity and the greater trochanter of femur. This is the lesser trochanter. The ischiofemoral ligament will be attached on ischial tuberosity, between ischial tuberosity and the entire ischium. So therefore here we show this ligament will be attached on the ischium. It will be attached on ischium, above the ischial tuberosity. So the entire ischiofemoral ligament will take its attachment on the hip bone, where from ischium, which is present above the ischial tuberosity. The fibers will pass upwards, backwards, in this direction, upwards, backwards, behind the neck of the femur. As the fibers pass upwards, backwards, and laterally, behind the neck of the femur. See the direction of fibers, upwards, backwards, laterally, behind the neck of the femur. They will then merge with inner layer of fibrous capsule. Remember in the starting I have mentioned inner layer of fibrous capsule, circular fibers which are called zona orbicularis. So therefore, these fibers will merge with zona orbicularis. And zona orbicularis is the inner circular layer of fibrous capsule. So this is the attachment of ischiofemoral ligament, which is asked in one mark question answer or MCQ. One attachment of ischiofemoral ligament is from ischium. The direction of fibers will be upwards, backwards, laterally behind the neck of femur. And another attachment of ischiofemoral ligament will be the fibers will merge with zona orbicularis. What is zona orbicularis? It is the circular fibers which form the inner layer of fibrous capsule. So here we finish all the 8 ligaments of hip joint. Thank you very much.